clearly stated that the scribes of the Old Testament say the righteous of this thing, you the righteous of this thing, right now, because we were made to light. We were made in our being, in our core, in our body, to God. We're a person who were made in the image of God. God, as we said about earlier, is light. God is sent Jesus Christ, God is here for you, walking in earth, which is the place of God, and he says, I love my people, I want to walk among them, be among them, live among them, breathe among them. And he's doing that work, he's done multiple times, in multiple places. Keep my commandments. Keep my commandments. He said in Matthew 28, he said, if you love me, he said, look, the disciples, brothers and sisters, keep them to obey. Abundant life that God has promised to abundant life that God has given us before. He has to make your life small. He's made your life incredible. He's made your life to be abundant. He's made your life overflowing with grace, with mercy, with love, with joy, with hope, even in the middle of suffering and trial. He's made you fit. They already have said that to my people, that the glory of God is the man and the woman, full. If you want to enter life, keep my commandments. If you love me, keep my commandments. You kill all this, you set all this down. Not because you needed something for yourself, but because God wants what's best for you. Because he wants what's best for you. He's for you. He's with you. He's recklessly in love with you. He says, look, brothers and sisters, sons and daughters, keep my commandments, please. Because they're the key to life, they're the narrow gate, they're the way you can get to what you're going to. Keep them. And that keeping doesn't mean perfection, it means intention and progression. But none of us are perfect. Keep them on the ground, set time with them, make it for them, keep vigil with them, keep working towards them, keep holding on to them. How do I do this? It's over 1,000 different commandments. How do I pick my way through? Where do I start? Is confused by the church that's not working, love the Lord your God with all my soul, be connected to it, be acceptable, be holding a part of his life, and that's the one thing that God too is love your neighbor as yourself. The torture people, the kill people, the cause people, because the cause will let them go. The death will save us. Because we love God. God is the man that is the gospel. We're committed to exercise what God views as the evil, the manifest best in the world. Because we love God. Every single other human being on the face of the planet. You're not going to be able to do it. Nobody else is going to be because of a skin color, because of socioeconomic status, because of a language. All of you are your neighbors. And that one commandment that was your own hand, the key to life, the middle way, that says, love the Lord your God with all your heart, mind, soul, and strength, and love your neighbor. He has changed you in the sense that you are my son or daughter, no matter what you believe, no matter what age you are, no matter how you spend your entire life right now, God is for you, He is on your side, you are his son or daughter, He is recklessly in love with you, He is talking to you, He is trying to get your attention, He loves you. We are not the person who starts that story. We're not the one who chose to love God first. By what he's done for you, for the first place of praying to him, he's right now facing this, that the Holy Spirit will overwhelm you with how much God loves you. That you are what it does, how small group you do, how much you do it, does it matter? God loves you, says recklessly. Stop performing. You don't have to. God hopes that you love the Lord. We don't need our stuff if we know that God has us to be faithful. We don't need that rope, we don't need that work, we don't need that money, we don't need that stuff. It's the only place that you're going to love your neighbor from. Otherwise, how can you love your neighbor? What? Lots of food being cooked at the moment. This creates lots of what in the sink. Everyone get it. Creates lots of what in the sink. Feces. Five. Good night. So I'm going to do the dishes. I'm going to do the dishes. You missed it, Martha had a dream in it. I didn't say that. To myself, this is going to make my life happy. And I'm processing the message. I'm also processing what I'm talking about. I said, wait a minute. If I follow this logic that God has passed, it's actually a selfish decision. I'm doing the distance so that my life will tell me how awesome I am. So that I will feel good about myself. Phrase that many of us have been used. But I want you to examine it. When you really say it's the truth, so that my life will never happen, so that my life is easy. We love something or someone we promote is good and right for its own sake. That's simple. Love your God. Love your God. Love your God. Love your God. Love your neighbor. Notice what he doesn't say. He talks about loving your neighbor. Then he says, oh, love the entire world. Love the world. Love well. Jesus Christ, God is telling you to do that. Give you life. It's really simple. He says, love your neighbor. I'll take care of it. You do your job best. Your job is to love your neighbor, the person right in front of you, your family, your actual physical neighbor. You do that work. You see, what I think happens to us, it's so easy for us, especially in our current culture, to love all groups of people. Yes, I love the world. I just don't have a relationship. Oh, yes, I love the poor. I just can't pay somebody who's poor. I can't tell you somebody's poor story. I can't have somebody who's poor to my house. I love the undocumented. I'm for them. When it comes to my own life, you know that story. I love you for a moment. But Jesus knew what he was doing when he was doing this to him. You know where they're divided up from. You know where they are. There's this road, there's that road, there's this road, there's this side, there's that side. How many of you can tell why the majority of folks know what the majority of folks do doesn't present to you? You lose. Thank you. Thank you.